So we made it to Gatwick. Spent a half hour or more trying to find a place to call it a night. Managed to find this spot, which I don't really know if I'd call it that great of a spot. I was just woken up by two guys trying to figure out where they could do something involving construction that may happen right above my head. I'm not sure, so I might need to move. I don't actually need to be going through security for another half hour or more. And security was closed when I got here. It's about 3:30, something to 4. Flight leaves at 6:30. It's going to be a long night, a long morning, however you want to look at it.
Either way, got to see a bit of London. It was worth it.
And I'll sleep on the plane for 2 hours. Oh wow. Woohoo. It's like 4:30 in the morning, maybe 4:45. Who wants to go shopping right now? Is it a thing where you like wake up and go, I need a dress shirt? If you do, Gatwick Airport has you covered. So I opted to get up. It didn't seem like I was going to get much sleep. And security was open, I came through. And now I'm in the departures area, which is so much better than the other side of Gatwick Airport. And on top of that, managed to find myself a pretty decent meal. Shout out to Sean from the Fat Gay Vegan, who pointed me to the fact that the Prêt à Manger had vegan options, which they do. Lots of things labeled as vegan or veggie with the lovely Vegan Society symbol on them. Got, Chana flatbread, lovely coconut yogurt, and a ginger shot because I'm feeling like crap, and I'm hoping that that's going to sort of help, because like I said earlier, I've got a long day ahead of me. But for now, I'm going to eat and drink, and then I'm going to go see where my flight is because I'm so early that they don't even know where the plane's going to be. Fun times. So, just for the record, if I ever do this again, I'm going to need to try and get to Gatwick before security closes, because just this section alone in the departures lounge has more chairs than pretty much all of what I saw on the other side of security. Yeah, they've got armrests and they're kind of worn out, but it probably would have done me better than what I did sleep in. So, yeah, if you're going to sleep in Gatwick, make it past security before you settle down for the night. So, I made it into Sweden, no questions asked, literally. He just took my passport, stamped it, looked at me for a second, and gave it back. Now I'm going to go find a bus or a coach or something to get into the city and make my way to my friend, and then the Swedish adventure begins. So let's see how this goes. Figured the bus out okay. Now I'm soon gonna get off this bus and start trekking around in the subway system. I've done it before, but it was many years ago. That being said, I don't think it's gonna be too difficult. And it should be a pretty quick trek. And then I've got out with my friend, and the rest of it is just hanging out with her and checking out Stockholm and getting some work done and basically pretending that I live here for the next 3 weeks. First, I need to get on the subway.